I'm a visual artist, and my specialty is textiles. So I like to think of myself as someone who thinks about textiles in very broad, broad ways, but deeply rooted in the history of textiles. Art has always been challenging to me, and I love that challenge. Every day, every moment, am I living this moment artfully? Am I connecting with someone? Is there an artful moment happening? And am I noticing it and framing it? And what will I do with that later? Hi, you guys. Welcome. Come on in. But my studio is actually back here in these two rooms, so why don't you come on in and I'll show you. One of the things about the studio is it's a very active space. And it's active because we're making work, we're coming up with ideas for work, and we're shipping artwork out. So one of the things that I've been doing for a long time is thinking about textiles in terms of their connection to hair. So a lot of my work is related to hair and textiles and the bridge between those two. Lots and lots of hair references. In fact, a friend of mine cut her hair, and I actually used her hair to make a piece in the last show. It's not just her hair, it's her. And then I like to think of it even beyond that, that if it's her DNA, then it's all the people who came before her that are written in her DNA. So it's powerful stuff, hair. So I have to be very careful about, or think very consciously about whose hair I use and how and why. The question of why I use hair in my work, it's such a potent material. It is our actual physical human DNA. So it's a ready-made portraiture. It's also a place in which we, in this country, still negotiate race. So this is something that we keep around in the studio because it's sort of the little wig template. And this, it was on a piece like this, or perhaps this piece that I figured out, the cornrows and the Bantu knots for the black hair flag piece. And the thread was all made out of cotton. The battle flag of the Confederacy was painted on canvas, and then it was stitched just like this, and the cornrows and then the Bantu knots are what make the American flag on the surface. So in this case, it's not that I'm using hair, it's that I'm using hair styling techniques and thread to refer back to African and African-American identity. So there's this long, rich tradition of working with hair across the globe and through many cultures. And I just like to think that I'm part of that continuation of that conversation. This is a bow that is rehaired with human hair. This one that looks quite gray is made with my hair. All three races are implied because a blonde hair is actually not from a European person. It's from an Asian person, and then the hair has been bleached blonde. There's this other thing just about the prize being drawn around the circle of being a Southern artist. Because one of the things about now living in Virginia, specifically living in Richmond, Virginia, as the seat of the Confederacy, and how much that has affected the way that I think about this nation and the dialogue that we have around our national identity and our own history, and how those sort of conversations and ideas have infused my work, it's that much more touching to have a prize that has that as its mission. So I'm thrilled. I mean, how could I not be thrilled? I'm absolutely thrilled, and I'm really grateful to the Gibbes for awarding me the honor.